Jesus claim to be God? No answer. Where did he claim? You said he said directly and indirectly. I didn't hear. Not directly, not indirectly. I gave you 7 questions. Where in the Bible did Jesus claim to be God? No answer. Where in the Bible did Jesus ask to be worshipped? Ah, you said that he accepted worshipping. I'm coming to this now. Where did Jesus say, I am God manifested in flesh? Nowhere. Where did Jesus mention the original sin? The reason why he came, the reason why he manifested? It is not mentioned in the 4 Gospels. Where did Jesus say, I am God the Son or God the Word? Nowhere. Where did he say, he is second God in the Trinity? Where did, the question number 8, where did he say that he have two natures? Where did Jesus say this? Jesus spoke openly and in secret, didn't say anything. Now, you use say and say, Son of God. So, when you read, Son of God is not God the Son. You cannot bring even one verse says God the Son. But you say Son of God means that Jesus is something. Okay, let's see. So, you say Jesus is God because he is Son of God. I have a question. Where did Jesus say God the Son? There is a lot of verses that say God the Father. Like I showed. So if Jesus is God and equal to Father, why we cannot find even one verse says God the Word or God the Son? Simply because the only true God is the Father alone. Jesus referred to himself as Son of Man 83 times. And only once Son of God in not direct way, in John 10:37. If I do not the works of my Father, believe me not. So what we do? When he also says in John 20:17, Jesus says unto her, Touch me not, for I am not yet ascended to my Father, but go to my brethren and say unto them, I ascended unto my Father and your Father, and to my God and your God. What we should do now? The Bible says to us that God does not change. In Malachi 3:6, For I am the Lord, I change not, therefore you sons of Jacob are not consumed. And Bible says, God is not a man. In Hosea 11:9, I will not exclude, for I am God and not man. I already mentioned you those verses. The Bible shows us a lot of sons of God. Adam is son of God, in Luke 3:38. Solomon is son of God, in Corinthians 1:17-13. David is son of God in Psalms 2:7. I will declare the decree. The Lord has said unto me, Thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. And by the way, the word begotten was omitted from the Bible now. Angels are children of God also. In Luke 20:36. Jesus even said in Matthew 6:9, After this manner therefore pray you, our Father which art in heaven. Huh? In your prayers, you pray like this, Our Father which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. All of Israel are sons of God, in Hosea 1:10. So son of God means servant or slave of God. It is used to describe righteous people. Same like those who followed Satan, they become sons of Satan due to the Bible. You can read that in verse John 8:44. Even the world have children metaphorically, in Luke 16:8. So what makes Jesus is different? Why son of God should mean for me or anyone understand it by reading it that he is God? Who said this? Because begotten or firstborn? Huh? Begotten was already omitted and it was used with David as I showed you. In Exodus 4:22, that says Jehovah, Israel is my son, even my firstborn. Huh? Worship Israel now. Jeremiah 31:9, I am a father to Israel and Ephraim is my firstborn. Firstborn means nothing. Psalms 2:7, already I mentioned this about David. Is because Jesus is the son of the Most High, like this verse in Luke 1:32, He shall be great and shall be called the Son of the Highest, and the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. But we can see that anyone can be the child of the Highest. Imagine this, Luke 6:35. But love you your enemies and do good and lend hoping for nothing again, and your reward shall be great, and you shall be the children of the Highest. The children of the Highest. for he is kind unto the unthankful and to the evil. Son of God, you cannot use this to assume that Jesus is God. Now, let's see. John 10:30. I and the Father are one. Can we say that Jesus is the Father? You said no. And you were very happy. Jesus is not the Father. Thank you, Muslim 25. You proved that Jesus is not the Father. Okay, so why you associate him to the only true God? If the God, the only true God is the Father alone. You are not believing in one God. You are a sharer. You are proving yourself to be a sharer. This is what you did. This is what you did. And we're very happy. I don't know why. See, the Father is not Jesus. And Jesus is not the Father. So when we read John 10:30, I and the Father are one. What we understand? They are one in purpose, in aim, in goal. And this is very clear from the context. Otherwise, you would be committing heresy, and we don't want you to make that, right? Interesting that he used verses, John 10:32 and 30, as far as I remember, he used John 31 and 32. But why didn't you read the context, 33 and 34? Let's read together, John 10:31 to 34. Then the Jews took up stones again to stone him. Jesus answered them, many good works have I showed you from my Father. For which of those works do you stone me? The Jews answered him, saying, for a good work we stone thee not, but for blasphemy, and because that thou, being a man, makest thyself God. In John 10:34, Jesus answered them, is it not written in your law, I said you are gods? I will ask you a question. Why Jews wanted to stone Jesus? We can find the answer here. In John 19:7, this verse exposes the writer of the Gospel of John. And here you will have a challenge, MBI. The Jews answered him, John 19:7, we have a law. They have a law. And by our law, he ought to die, because he made himself the Son of God. So they think, so now, if I say I am Son of God, I should be stoned. See, this is what the writer of Gospel of John tries to show, that Son of God, when used to Jesus, it means something. And this exposed the lies of the writer of Gospel of John. I challenge any Christian, I challenge, MBI, try to bring me law from Old Testament that says if someone says he is Son of God, he should be stoned. Imagine that we search all the Old Testament and we couldn't find such a law. There is no problem at all in New Testament, Old Testament, if someone says he is Son of God. For example, in New Testament, John 8:41, you do the deeds of your father. Then said to him, we be not born of fornication. We have one Father, even God. And from Old Testament, in Hosea 1:10, you are the sons of the living God. Now prepare yourself for another cut and paste. We were talking about cut and paste game in same verse. The writer of John Gospel always tried to show that Jews wanted to stone Jesus because he said that he is Son of God. In verse John 10:34, Jesus reminds them what is written in Old Testament. Let's read together. John 10:34. Jesus answered them, is it not written in your law, I said you are gods? Now let's see where is that written in Old Testament. In Psalms 82:6. Psalms 82:6. I have said you are gods. But the writer of Gospel John didn't write the next part. And all of you are children of the Most High. All Jews are children of the Most High. See? Cut and paste. Why they cut second part of what is said in Psalms? Why they didn't write that all Jews are children of the Most High? Simply because the unknown writer of the Gospel of John tried to show to us that by Jesus saying that he is Son of God, this means he broke the law. I challenge any Christian to bring me a law from Old Testament that says if someone says he is Son of God, he should be stoned, as the writer of John wrote in John 19:7. Do you want to know why Jews wanted to stone Jesus? Why don't you read the context? Please, anyone, post verses John 10 from verses 22 to 30. 22 to 30 or 31, no problem. John 10,